What's going on, everybody? We are back with Evo Pools. My name is Coney, joined
by the one and only Senpai.
There we go. We're getting ready to cast some more pool stuff going on. You know how it is. The top players are making their way through the ranks. I was looking at the upset thread. Mm-hmm. I didn't see anything crazy.
Yeah, I was going to say, anything crazy happened in there yet? Or
not really. It's been pretty quiet. But then again, I didn't get that deep into it. Like, maybe it's been I got to be honest. I've been at the pool pretty much all day.
Fair enough. Yeah, there's lots of good food here. Gambling you could do. All that.
I've been just big chilling. But we were just talking before I went on. Nowhere to get ice cream.
Yeah, where's the ice cream?
I
don't
know.
They got freezy drinks. They got, you know, snacks, coffee, but
pretzels
no ice cream.
Pretzels everywhere. If you're trying to get Johnny Rockets, like, they got, like, eight of them. If you want burgers, like, milkshakes galore. But no ice cream.
$10 for one slice of pizza, no big deal.
Oh, my God. So I was... My fat ass. I was like, all right, I'm going to go to the beach area, right? And I'm going to get a drink. And those Reese's look really good.
Yeah.
So I go there. I get the Reese's and a Rockstar so I can get some energy. $11.
No, thanks. I got two waters yesterday, $10.
Oh, no.
Let's get it.
That hurts. All right. So who we got here? We got Propane, whose sponsor is Hank Hill. I don't know how he got that illustrious that team. Up against the King. You're putting. Okay, got you. Up against King Killa from Guam.
Okay.
Who's going to be playing Clouds. We got Cloud against Yoshi coming up.
Yeah, we have some very interesting representation. Love Evo having so many people from so many different walks of life. I see Scotland right in there. A lot of USA, Japan, Europe.
Austria, too.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's really cool to see people representing from all over.
It's super nice. And then you have some, like, secret killers like E-King, who he's number one in – oh, gosh, I don't want to get the country wrong. But he's number one in his country somewhere, and he plays Pac-Man. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about Propane against King Killa coming up first. This is Cloud against Yoshi. And I remember this matchup being really hard for Yoshi in the past. I feel like with Cloud getting neutered a little bit, it might not be as bad.
Right. And yeah, I hear a lot of complaints about this character, Yoshi, man. Just mad about the eggs, I think. I don't know exactly what it is.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know anybody that hates this character. Good cross slash there. So much damage. I feel like Cloud in this game is just like B moves.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Up B out of shield, side B to do tons of damage. Like,
absolutely. I mean, even though Limit fades away now, you can just utilize that right away.
Yeah.
All right, he's trying to catch this man right now in the air. And of course, he does with that cross slash. Like, we're talking about B moves all day.
You have to be really careful against Cloud, too, because, like, especially as Yoshi, because sometimes you can reach a little bit. We talked about how his aerial mobility, he can kind of go in super hard, but if you overextend just a little bit, especially against Cloud, especially when he has Limit, you're going to pay dearly.
Yeah, we just saw him do exactly that. Down a stock right now, 57% only on Cloud, and he has that Limit already. Of course, going to rip it again.
Yeah, no reason not to if the dude's just kind of, like, sitting in your face. Just keep going for it.
Exactly, and like we said, it fades away, so you got to do it when you can.
King Killa really impressing me here. He's from Guam. I'm not sure of his, like, ranking. Maybe he's, you know, really strong in his region. I know Guam, a very, very tiny island nation.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I'm not sure how big their scene is, but he's definitely holding his own here against Propane.
Exactly. For representing for all of them right now. Keeping this Yoshi off the stage. Having so much trouble getting on the board tilt going to take him out still. I haven't seen Propane really be able to find his footing just yet. He's sort of chasing Cloud around and allowing him to put out whatever he wants.
Yeah, not even 100% here. That is insane.
How did he read that roll from so far away, man? Okay. Oh, not on the board just yet.
No, he had to air dodge, though. And excellent timing on that. I like the usage of that climb hazard, though, because, like, you know you're probably not going to make it back. Just get the free damage.
Might as well get the damage.
Exactly.
And you could throw them off. They might try to do an air dodge or something and accidentally SD.
Exactly.
All right, he's on the hunt once again, chasing him real high. I like how he backed away immediately, knowing that the back air was going to come out.
Good weight on that.
Oh, and the fall through the platform up air.
Super good. Cloud still can be kind of oppressive if he's below you. Not nearly as much as in the past game, but he still has to be reckoned with. Yeah, he's got that limit. He's going to...
Yeah, you know exactly what's going to happen. There it is.
And I don't know if it's just me, but I feel like Clouds are using Blade Beam, Limit Blade Beam, so much more than they did in the past.
And I love his positioning on it, too, because he was probably planning for that Yoshi to roll backwards, but it didn't matter if he went in front of him or not. It was going to connect. Beautiful stuff right there.
Super good.
Really putting on for all of Guam right now. Okay. Respect it.
Yeah, no big surprise there. I definitely feel like Yoshi would want to go here more than anybody else. Cloud, of course, this was kind of his home in the past game, but without his ability to juggle as much, don't know if we're going to see that. We're backing up. Oh, I was going to, I was like, are we making a me?
Yeah, like never mind. Okay, no, we're going to change the song. That's very important, all right, for your mental game, especially it looks like he has his headphones plugged into the game there. You want to be able to hear what you want.
Yeah. And honestly, I'm so glad that we have setups that we can use that audio, because I think at a lot of places you don't have the audio. So big shouts to Astro for providing these headsets, letting players be able to hear the action. That is so important, especially against certain characters like Snake.
I was going to say, yeah, you want to be able to hear that little C4 get set down, man. Shout outs to Astro. All right, but we're going to start out, on Battlefield this time around. And I do see why Yoshi would come here, but I don't know if I'd want to bring Cloud to the stage.
Yeah, I feel like this could be very polarizing. Like, Yoshi definitely wants to shark under people with up airs, get that up tilt into up air string. But Cloud, he can do that. He can use that climb hazard. And if I'm not mistaken, could be wrong about this, but I think he can do it to the top platform safely.
Yeah.
So it's basically, you know, without risk.
Yeah, borderline. You can just get away with that. And he's swinging these back airs right now, trying to catch Yoshi. And I like how he went all the way above him. Just going to avoid everything that Cloud's going to put out. On the chase here.
Gonna try to stop him from landing. Excellent, just holding the shield, not jumping out, wants to hold still. But I didn't realize that until just now. That down air of Cloud's is gonna make it really tough for Yoshi to be able to juggle him in the air. We didn't really see much of that the first game, but in this game, I could definitely see it being a problem.
Exactly, and he's trying to, like you said, shark underneath these platforms, but he's not gonna get that opportunity if he keeps putting the down air out. And also, King Killa very smart with his shield and defensive play when he needs to be.
Yep.
All right, getting thrown off the stage here. Much more even game than the last one, though, so maybe Propane's starting to figure this one out a little bit.
Yeah, for sure. Excellent work. And I think what King tried to do there is use that side B to turn around so we could use back air as he came back. But unfortunately, just used it a little bit too close. Yoshi's aerial drift, just nothing to sneeze at. So good.
Yeah, absolutely not. He's going to get punished hard for that one. And now Propane with the first lead of the set. Looking kind of okay right now. If he can get out of this corner, but of course not.
No.
Going to lose that first stock here. All right, Genkai will Kaidu online. Get him with the, oh, I love that up tilt into the cross slash attempt. Didn't quite get it, but beautiful.
Yeah. Oh, and this is where things get tough. We talked about this. We didn't know if Cloud could do it as much, but he's doing it, and there it is, the climb hazard on the top platform.
Exactly what you said. And catching him even with a nair, just not allowing Yoshi to land at all, but finally finding his feet here, having an opportunity with stage control. The tilt barely did not connect. I don't know if that was Cloud's animation of that up tilt that stopped him from getting hit, but either way, he did not. Ah, he already used this jump.
Oh, I didn't realize that. All right, we're throwing out every taunt.
And
there we go. Go for it, whatever.
Yikes, and another blade beam for you into a climb hazard. I don't know what these combos are, but they're connecting.
I'm telling you, man, he's B-moves. Like, that's what he is now, you know? It's all specials, and it's funny because, like, his normals were what were oppressive in the last game,
right.
But Yoshi just seems to really struggle. And despite how close that first stock was, Propane is just struggling to get anything on the board.
My man can't even land right now, finally getting his feet on the stage. And goes for a fair, a little risky here. Climb hazard going to connect. Escaping to that top platform. You saw King was already ready to punish it, but just a little bit too late. Oh!
Close, yeah. Oh.
What a spicy way that would have been to go out here.
138 going to just toss it using the armor. There we go, that flutter jump. Super
Very
good.
Very smart, and he waited so long, too.
Yeah.
I think King thought he had that, because he definitely threw out a couple taunts there.
For sure. Thought that was the end, but I mean, like, even with that,
Yeah, this is a long way to go for Propane.
That's tough. There's the cross slash again, 172. He's only got 29%, and he hasn't been hit for a very long time.
All right, finally getting it on there. Oh, but the DI was not quite right. He's going to lose his stock here and the set.
That's going to do it. Remember, all these games are going to be 2 out of 3 all the way up into finals, which is something.
That's something. It is
sure.
a fact. Either way.
Oh, boy. That's going to be insane because, like, so many players need that 3 out of 5,
Absolutely.
You know, to sort of adapt to get a hold of their opponent, especially against certain characters.
Yeah.
Because I think there are some characters that can kind of, like, they can win the 2 out of 3, but maybe they can't win the 3 out of 5.
That's true. That's
so
very true.
I'm really interested to see how those players sort of go throughout the tournament up until the finals because, I mean, I felt like there'd be so many more upsets than we've seen so far.
Yeah, I can see that. And especially when it comes to, like, characters that, like, zone or something like that. I feel like you get zoned out for, like, 2 games, but by the third one, you figure out how to get past him. You're getting your parries on and stuff like that. But no opportunity for that in this tournament, unfortunately.
Yeah,
better adapt fast.
Yeah, it's a different skill set, right? Because you got to think about something else. You got to do it in a different way. So we'll see what players are best at that. And coming up now is a player that is best at a different game, but we'll see how he does here. It's Toph, baby.
Hey, okay, sitting down right now. And, you know, I don't know if you guys heard about this, but a player named Leon, that Bowser, you know, he was supposed to make it out to this tournament, wasn't able to do it. So they made a GoFundMe to try to get him here, and Toph dropped all the money immediately to try to help that, you know, wonderful Bowser player get out here, but unfortunately still couldn't make it.
You got it like that, Toph?
Right? Good guy,
$600?
I can't believe he did. What a nice guy, man. Seriously.
Yeah, he's just, what a saint. Jeez.
Look at that smile on his face. Yeah. Just kind.
He's just here to have a good time. Let's see how he does it. Oh, yes. Oh, okay. There we go. So he.
What?
So he's. I look at the smirk. Okay, so I tweeted like 5 Joe Biden tweets of the 3-0-3-3, just different things. And now he's got it as his tag. I love
it. Nice. Let's go, Toph. Okay. And then on the other side, we have Ash with the Pikachu hat. He's definitely going to be using Pikachu, let's be real here. If he doesn't, then I don't know what to say.
Yeah, definitely repping for the seam right now, playing the Pikachu. And you got those players that are just so into their characters. I saw people, dude picked, I think Sirius Kyle picked Game & Watch, had the Game & Watch shirt. You get people so into it at EVO. And I feel like there's more of that at EVO than any other tournament.
That's very fair, yeah. Especially when you think there's a chance you might get on stream. You want to wear your best outfit, your coolest little... That Pikachu hat is nice, man.
Of course.
It could be a bait, though. Like, walk up with the Pikachu hat and then
imagine.
Pick, like, Palutena or something.
Yeah.
That's
really
the way to
ruin someone's day.
Even with the Ash name and everything. Oh, no. He's going to be real about it.
It's a Pikachu, and it looks like Toph is actually going to be playing Inkling. So a man after my own heart.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, I was definitely playing Inkling when the game first came out. I'm surprised that Toph would play it because I personally feel like Inkling is a character that you have to invest a lot of time to see any kind of reward because they are volatile, to say the least.
Right.
Not in a great way, unfortunately. Yeah. We saw how Cosmos has sort of had some upsets.
That's very true. This is definitely a character that in the first few weeks we were pretty tilted by. With, you know, like you see right now, the Rapid Jet Ink, it does, look at that, almost 30% after the first hit. And then it's all that ink on you. You're going to take more damage and more knockback.
Not against the ledge, Toph.
68? Yeah, I was going to say this, man, fully covered too. We got purple Pikachu out here.
Yeah, just unlocking new skins. It's amazing.
All right, if he can get his feet on the ground here, though. Okay, Pikachu's turn to start up a little combo.
Yeah, nice. I like the up tilts, the up airs. Pikachu, he's going to want to stay on top of him. I like the forward air, and now Ash has actually taken the lead. And this matchup is one that I've played a lot myself. It's one of those things that whoever gets that first KO is going to be way ahead because both of these characters can struggle to kill, and Toph coming out just with that roller, not a wise decision.
Yeah, I mean, I always get hit by that, but my man Ash was ready with the force mash, but okay, good mash. And you saw, I love that when people mash so hard, they accidentally put out something.
Yep.
Especially when it connects and you get the stock or something off of it. It's like, yeah, I totally meant to do that.
Oh, but it's so tilting when you do it off stage and you just like up B out of an egg or something. Oh, no.
Very tragic. But either way, right now, he's trying to carry him off the side here.
Yeah, and we were played by Toph because Ash actually just landed in front of him with Skull Bash and Toph didn't do anything.
Yeah.
Looks like Ash is just solidly coming out ahead here at 131. And you see Inkling's kind of weakness is that getting that KO can be really tough.
Exactly. And you saw him trying to fish for that back air right there, but Pikachu's forward air much more disjointed, and he's going to have an easier time connecting. Okay, I like the down tilt real quick. Just going to catch up to Pikachu.
Still not going to be enough to KO, though. That's the thing. Like, forward smash wouldn't be fast enough. Up smash wouldn't come out. So what do? You just get the down tilt, but at 154, that stock is rotten. It has to go.
Absolutely. He's trying to just get his feet on the stage here, let alone find the stock. All right, weak hit of that back air. Unfortunate. Could have been it.
Tries to go for the forward tilt. That might have done it. Gets the roller. He has all the time in the world at that one.
Yeah, I was going to say. And I like the way he mixed up his movement right there before going for that roller. Sort of looked like he was going to go, you know, maybe jump for an aerial or something like that, but instead just roller.
Really like his use of dash dance there, being a little deceptive, but I feel like that's Pikachu's most used, you know, kill sort of setup, is just dash dancing back and forth and then forward smashing where you're going to land. If Toph can just avoid that, I feel like he could survive way longer. Still might be able to take this.
Yeah, absolutely. Right, this grab situation right now, he's going to find his way back onto the stage. Oh, just going to go low, really smart. Ash kind of doing a weird edge guard right there.
Yeah. Not sure what that was. I really like the use of ink, though.
Definitely. Hitting him at a distance with it, too. Didn't care that the jabs didn't properly connect. He still got the ink on him.
Yeah. It's the forward smash. You gotta respect it, and I feel like that's a move that Toph might not be intimately familiar with, just because, like, Pikachu, you gotta fight against Pikachu to know it. Pikachu is not a common character, and Toph, you know, he does not main ultimate, you know?
So.
But he seems to be doing really well. Dying to an up air, though, at 183.
Ooh. Yeah, I mean, he held onto that stock for quite a long time. Like you said, 183, not too bad to go out at. And now he has all the all the stage control in the world right now to catch his Pikachu. Ooh, that's what you get for trying to style underneath the stage!
Oh, no!
Getting stage spike with a splat bomb, not the best feeling in the world, and suddenly it's an even game.
Yeah, that's a disaster, especially because he was, like, an entire stock up.
Right.
47 now. This is kind of how we saw the first stock end up, and then Toph kind of gave it away.
Right.
Ash might be regretting that decision.
It'd be one thing if he went under the stage to wait out the invulnerability, but the way Ash has been playing, I don't know. He's been doing some dash dancing stuff.
Yeah.
I think he wanted to do a little bit of style there, and it did not go well for him.
Yeah, sometimes the Evo stage be crazy.
Exactly.
It messes you up. Good forward smash again, just kind of using that Pikachu forward smash where Toph is going to land.
Wow, and I'm surprised he got that forward air out before the forward smash connected. Good to not roll back into that Pikachu forward smash.
Jumps out of the roller. Gonna try to make it out, gets the back air. Let's see what the tech chase is. Just goes for the jab. And Ash has done that twice now, where what he'll do is he'll wait for the second jab, but he'll get it out before the gun comes out, which is super good.
Yeah.
Just being able to react to that, because if the gun is coming out, it's gonna be way harder to punish.
Exactly. And catching him right there on landing, gonna get the forward smash that he's looking for finally, and take game one. Toph taking his headphones off, maybe a little too loud for him or something, just wants to calm down, play the game at his own pace.
Sure. Let's see what the stages are. Battlefield again. And I didn't see any up throw anything from Toph. And I feel like I don't think the grabs really happen much at all.
Yeah, I don't know if he's that familiar with the character, to be
fair.
Like you said, he doesn't main this game. He's just doing his best out here right now.
Yeah. I just feel like with Inkling, you need up throw, up air, up throw, back air. You know what I mean? You need the grab combos to be able to open up a stock.
Yeah, like you said, this is definitely a character you need to be very familiar with to do well with. You can rack up a ton of damage with Inkling, sure.
Yes.
But how are you finding these stocks?
Yeah. It's another back air. Ash in a good position under Toph. He's struggling to land now at the ledge, but he just gets right off with the roller.
Yeah, I like the mix-up right there. Just going to come from the sky and have a hitbox out there for him.
Gets another roller, and it doesn't look like Ash is really punishing him for it, so he's just kind of, you know, kind of pulling it out whenever
exactly.
he needs to.
Okay, that was one of those scenarios of who's going to grab first.
Right.
They don't Ash to have the quick fingers, but now trapped off the stage right
Ooh.
Now. Oh, great down air. Tried to catch him with the forward air off the skull bash. Very good. Ooh, okay, that roller kind of biting him for a second.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm seeing a lot of, like, habits that a lot of people have when they first fight Pikachu. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like, you need a long session against this character. And that's not a knock against Toph. You know, he's a great player in his own right, but Pikachu, just such a unique character. And in Melee, there's one Pikachu.
Right,
like,
exactly.
he doesn't exist as a character. He's just one guy. He's grabbing the ledge twice.
Okay, so he is going to be able to get that down tilt out of it at least. And I love the quick attack mix-ups. He actually has been landing in a different spot every single time when he comes on stage with it.
Yes.
Oh, forward air not fully connecting.
Doing okay, 84, trying to use that dash dance to be a little ambiguous. Gets hit by the down air, but he's going to be able to make it back. He does have low ink, though, so he's got to knock him away and charge up. There
it is. Yeah, good on him to be aware, but the skull bash is going to take him out now. But 105%, man, maybe he can find a roller here, make something happen, get this even again.
He's been hitting him. I feel like it's been happening less and less as Ash is just kind of holding shield, but Toph has been able to hit them in the past game, so if he can do it again, he should be okay here.
But you can see Pikachu just waiting. Ash is very smart about this matchup right now. Just going into his shield and catching him as soon as he tries to land on stage.
Yeah, again. Good air dodge by Toph getting to the ledge. There's the roller. What's the play?
Okay.
Perfect. Yeah, well executed.
And
not necessarily easy to do. I see a lot of Inklings mess that up.
Oh, absolutely. And people can mash out of that so fast sometimes.
Yeah.
It just varies from player to player. All right, but great combo right here off the platform. Trying to catch him off stage again. Forward smash coming through.
Not again. Okay, I see.
Okay.
Whenever I see two, I think there's three, you know?
And that actually can work sometimes, too. It'll definitely throw a player off. Like, he won't do it a third time, and then you're dead.
Dash tech again. Toph trying to land. Gets hit by the back air. Off stage again. The ink is coming out, but good back air by Ash. He does not have an air dodge now. Is Ash going to go out there? Nope.
Oh, going to hit his head on the bottom of the stage right there.
Ugh.
Yeah, definitely not the best recovery, and now down an entire stock, only 28 on Pikachu.
Yeah, and that's not a character you want to be this down on, because, like, Pikachu's going to up air you, up tilt you, and basically get, like, it's a Pikachu tax. It's free damage.
Exactly.
What are you going to do?
All right, but getting this ink on here immediately, and if he can get some nice hits in real quick, might be able to bring this in close, but suddenly Pikachu turning it around on him.
Yeah. It's great if you get the ink. It's not great if you do nothing with it,
exactly.
you know?
Exactly. And it's interesting, Ash doesn't even play, you know, most people play slow when they have ink on them, try to wait for it to fade away, but Ash not scared at all, dashing right in.
Ooh, almost gets the roller, but it clashes with the hitbox.
Yeah.
And I'm not seeing any shield grabs by Toph. That's got to be a Melee thing. That I haven't seen him grab much at all, but I feel like Ash is consistently kind of hitting him close to his shield. Excellent forward air, though, getting him right where that thunder was coming down. Toph, I really like the way that he placed that.
Yeah, extremely important spacing right there and actually catching him perfectly with it. Nice back air somehow.
Yeah, I saw that and I was like, wait, what?
It looked like he got hit at first, but no, okay, he's going to turn it on him. And now slowly trying to bring this one back. Full ink, got the roller hit.
Ooh, okay! No grab. Again.
Yeah, almost the combo right there would have been so clean. You're right. A grab would have been great into a back air or up air.
No.
Whoa, barely spot dodging the roller.
But you saw how he spaced the back air. It looks like Toph was, like, conditioning him by playing weird, like, poorly the whole set, but, like, that back air was spaced. That grab combo was amazing. Like, he's coming alive here.
And he just pecked that right there. Excuse me? Is this not a big game? Hold on. Not the roller.
Do it, do it. Ooh. Oh, so close.
He even had the spot perfect for where Pikachu was going to land. But, yeah, the air dodge just lasts a little bit too long. Oh, no. Unshielding that back air. Now he's in a horrible spot. Ooh.
Splat bomb off stage? Oh, no. I want to see a game three so bad. Yeah. I know I have to be impartial, but, I mean, like, Ash has been playing phenomenally. But I want to see how Taupe adapts. But, he's still living.
He can make it back to this. Go low. Yeah, I believe in that because Ash has been going out real far for those forward airs. You got to be careful here.
Just watch the forward smash, and he should be okay. But Ash, desperately trying to close out this stock, tries to get the throwback. Cannot get the up throw up air. We got the jab. He's out of ink.
Oh, he's out of ink. He goes for some. Very smart. You see him in it. Okay. Okay. Teching on the platform.
No! Big hit from the skull bash, that dash attack.
If he had ink right there, I think things would have been different. Very different.
That could have changed the course of history. Taupe, usually in good spirits, but he looked a little miffed about that because it was just...
I feel like it's the ink situation that bothered him because it's not like he played badly or anything. He did great, but that one spot right there, he had so much advantage.
That's tough. That is... That's a heartbreaker.
Yeah.
But what can you do? You have to see that. You have to be like, okay, well, next time, good stuff to Taupe, but better stuff to Ash, who's going to advance on. Taupe, of course, has a loser's bracket.
Yeah, so not out of this just yet. And coming up next, we have Uncivil Ninja versus Nut, the Bowser.
With two T's.
That's a good name for a Bowser.
Yes.
It really is.
That's if you hit that down B, just you hit the B button. Boom,
literally.
Nut, that's it.
All right, he better live up to that name. You cannot pick a name like that and get six stocked or something.
He definitely went to, like, the custom controllers. He's like, I need this on my B button. Just throw it there, and you slam it down. Yep. But he's going up against Uncivil Ninja, who, if I'm not mistaken, Shulk player from Florida?
Okay.
I think he's from Florida.
He's definitely a Shulk player, so you got that right.
No, he's Midwest.
Okay.
He's Midwest. He's Midwest or Florida.
Look, he's
one
USA,
of those two.
All right? So either way.
He's USA. Yeah, he's repping for the USA, of course, not also from USA. Choke against Bowser, gotta be honest, have not seen this matchup much.
Never seen this matchup, I don't think. Shulk, Bowser, I mean, to be fair, there's not that many Shulks. So.
Yes.
Yeah. Or Bowsers, for that matter. Definitely more of them, though, than Shulk.
Both characters that a lot of people have their eyes on and are like, okay, this character is nuts.
Yeah, I heard people saying Shulk was best in the game. I was like, I don't know about all that, but he definitely has some stuff going on.
Saying he was best in the game, saying he was top five. I know a lot of top players are like kind of flirting with the idea.
Right.
Like Larry has kind of been playing him a little bit.
Oh, I'd love to see that.
Yeah, Salem has busted him out a couple times.
I've seen that, yeah.
So I think he's got some players that kind of believe in it, but looks like we're going to have to see how Uncivil Ninja does. Meanwhile, Nut, of course, playing Bowser, who had a huge showing at Smash and Splash, if I'm not mistaken, Leon just going super far. And then just recently at that more recent tournament, just going crazy.
Yeah, this character just has some wild things. Even at Smash 4, he had some wild things where you don't want to get grabbed or be in the spot for a backer or a freaking F smash or something like that. But in this game, it seems like he has a much better neutral as well.
Yes, for sure.
Yeah, we'll see how Nut can do with it right now. And same with Uncivil Ninja. I mean, managing Monados and stuff like that seems hard, but, you know, in a couple weeks we're going to have to talk about managing the menu for Hero.
Oh, God. I just... part of me wonders if Heroes even have to, like... Like, how much are they... How much of it is them reading the menu, and how much of it is me having to read their menu? You know, because I've fought him, but I've only fought Hero Dittos.
Yeah,
and, like,
same.
I have to see how this character is going to function, like, in the actual...
Exactly. I'm going to keep it real. I don't think anyone's reading that menu. I think it's just...
No.
You just pick the
top
first
deck.
Option.
Top deck.
Yeah, or, or option C, just like with tests, you know? Standardized testing, pick option C, man.
C. Just throw it out. So I'm going to put you on the spot here. How many heroes in top 64 at SmashCon?
How many heroes?
How many are you going to see?
Oh, man.
And not like Nairo, like, oh, I'm going to use him for your game. No, I mean like hero mains. How many?
I'm going to say at least top 64?
Yeah.
Half.
Half?
Half.
Okay, you're crazy for that one. You want my answer? Zero. Uncivil Ninja against Nut happening here. PS2, because PS2 make the best games, always.
All right, yeah, so here we go right now. He's kind of working this man across the stage. Of course, Bowser combo food.
Yeah,
it's
tough.
And he's lucky to avoid that smash Monado coming out with all those aerials.
Yep. He's got the fruit punch Monado, but it looks like it's about to go out right as he lets that board smash rip. Untouched so far.
He wanted to get the grab and take him down with him, but unfortunately get a mission mark. Although I do like the idea with your 93-0.
I like the idea, unless the opponent's at zero. which he happened to be.
Oh, you can like, match that's, out of that too, right?
Yeah, okay, I don't know. I just, nice try, but he still has not been touched. He is just...
Please hit this man.
Yeah, please touch him. Fire breath.
Oh my god, he went for the forward smash. He's like, I'm not going out like this. I'm gonna hit you.
Let's just flame breath. Let's please.
Throw a fair.
Bro, one hit.
Dash attack.
Touch him. Yeah, there we go.
Let's go. He got that. He got that. We in there. 29% already on the board.
And now we got the speed. The cool blue raspberry back into the fruit punch. Too scary. That taste combination is deadly. Beautiful. Right, he's got the sour green apple. No.
Okay, please, it's not over yet. Yeah, he's back on the stage here, and now he's going to get the reverse restock.
Is he? We're making more calls, huh? half of heroes in top 64 and a reverse restock. Oh, no! All right.
I'm going to keep it real. He wasn't going to make it back to the stage if he didn't get down there. I'm sorry.
Like, how much are you mashing B? Like, you got to mash super hard. That was like a TAS bot. Like that whole thing looked like that Facebook video where it's like Epic Fox versus Falco on Final Destination.
Right, right.
That's what happened there. That Shulk just went crazy.
I only saw Shulk. Wait, what? I thought it was a two-man game. Like what? Okay, well, we're gonna get in the game too. He's gonna be in this one.
Just using all the colors of the rainbow.
I actually believe in him. All right. Okay, maybe not half hero mains. By the way.
Oh, we're going back to that. No.
Pocket
you can't
heroes,
do that now.
Pocket heroes. But to be fair, everyone's hero is a pocket hero at this point.
That's true, yeah. I feel like the character, I don't know, we'll see.
Like, yeah, it's like he has bad stuff, but then he got stuck.
Yeah. All you need is one Hocus Pocus, baby.
Exactly.
So maybe it was the stage that held Nut back, we'll see.
It was the stage,
for
right?
sure.
So here we go.
So we got Speed Monado.
On the board.
Yeah, Speed Monado art. Forgive me, Discord,
yeah,
I'm sorry.
Right.
So that makes him faster. I think it makes him take more knockback, but it also lets him combo the hell out of Bowser explicitly.
It really does.
Oh, my God.
Chasing this man all over the place right now. Got the jump Monado on. Oh,
oh my God.
If he had gone just a little further, but the jump going to run out in the last second, and now it's Nut who's in the lead here for the first time.
That's what you get.
Excuse me.
Just threw the fist down, clash with the Monado. All right, forward smash it when your opponent's at 16. I dig it. Okay.
I really do. I thought he was going to take him off.
Yes.
He should have, honestly.
No, I think he had a little bit more control on that just because he is down.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, so good stuff. He's going to be able to utilize the drift on that to be able to make it back, but not doing what he can.
Going for the Bowser Bomb right there. Very risky, and now trying to find himself back onto the stage. Smart on Ninja to not go too low this time around.
Nice. Good punish getting the forward smash. Realizing he didn't have anything else.
Yeah,
and I
exactly.
think Nut's in a good spot here. I mean, like, Uncivil Ninja kind of went crazy with that initial, you know, he kind of SD'd, but
yeah.
Nut really kind of putting it on here.
Exactly. At least he's holding on to this and actually pushing the advantage. Still in the lead a little bit, even though he just lost the stock. Oh, a parry. My man is in this right now, up an entire stock after that first game. He's not going out like that with a name like Nut. Come on.
Yeah, he's got to find his way back to the ledge, though. I feel like Uncivil Ninja putting on so much damage when Nut is off stage. Just these aerials are insane. The Buster gonna tack on so much damage.
Exactly, look at this right now. And I think he went into it initially seeing how small Bowser's shield was. He wanted to crack that thing. Okay, that'll take him out of this. Now it's an even game once again.
Yeah, the smash forward air is just insane. Even if you're off stage, but even just being on stage is just, you're not getting back. And just, I tweeted it out once that Shulk just be doing moves.
Yeah.
You know, it's
he
just.
He pushes buttons.
That's
man.
The sicko mode. He just short hops and just, you don't know what he's doing. He's taking all the vitamins. I don't know.
Exactly. And this man is in the air so much. I'm surprised how many of these forward smashes Nut's throwing out because that's not
going to
connect.
No, not again. Oh, my God.
I thought he could DI out of there for a second, but I guess not.
Not on Bowser.
He can change the future.
There we go.
He's got that up and everything. All right. I feel that. I feel that, Paul Wolf.
Could you imagine if that Monado was that small, like in the game? Yeah, like, it's like that big.
Oh, no. I'm glad that his... Yeah, it actually looks much cooler on Shulk. I'm sorry.
Yes.
That guy needs to get a slightly larger one.
You gotta, like, if you're gonna commission that, like, get somebody to make it, you need, like, the Buster Sword
exactly.
of Monado's.
Yeah.
You can't be coming out with, like, a dagger. That's so tiny.
Yeah, like the Joker, like, no. Don't do that.
That's ridiculous, yeah.
All right, but good games right there. Oh, Nico's coming up next. Wait, Falcon. Oh, that's not the Nico. That's Nico.
I don't know, because that's how he spells it. I thought the same thing. I was like, all right, are we getting double Shulk? He's sitting down now. I think it is him, because I was at Thunder Smash last weekend, Man was playing crazy amounts of Falcon.
Okay.
Like against the Buzz, against so many people. So I believe, yeah, that's him coming up to the stage representing Demise. So we'll see. I think he just realized that we just saw Shulk, and he's like,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, he's like, let me switch it up.
I can't top that.
Yeah, I guess so.
That set was so fast, and he's going to go against Don the Tiger playing Wolf.
Okay. I like that. Use the animal name and then use the animal character. I feel it. It's that synergy you get with your character outside of the game.
For sure. And I wish he got one of the jackets. Did you see those, the Tiger jackets? Those are so cool.
I haven't seen them.
Yeah, I think they're running out. It's like an Evo exclusive. If you guys are watching this from home, you might be able to pick it up at the shop. I don't know. Apparently, they're about to sell out super quick. Could also get this hoodie that I'm wearing. It looks mad nice.
You know, quick plug.
If I was at any other event, I would tell Vince to switch it back to me, but we're at Evo, so I'm going to be perfect.
Hey!
Ah, there we
don't
go.
Don't worry, he can get both screens.
Vince
no big deal.
Actually does his job for once. It's crazy. Thank you, but he's shaking his head.
Vince
he hates
is the best
me.
At his job, let's be real. But yeah, I do like that Evo hoodie. Make sure you guys get one of those. I believe we have discount code right now, Evo something.
Something like that. I couldn't tell you. I'm sure there will be an ad slide later.
There will be an ad. Don't you worry about that.
Yeah, just keep tuning in. So Don the Tiger up against Nico. Nico, of course, from SoCal, who really has not shown up in Ultimate. We were talking about that a little bit earlier. Like, the one SoCal rep, if I'm not mistaken, on the entire PGR, which was newly, you know, just revealed, was Void. He's
the only guy on it.
He
was saying something about it himself, and he's like, he doesn't feel like he's getting the exact training that he wants. He wants his region to, like, step it up a little bit more and, like, help compete with him. And, you know, they're trying out here. It's rough. It's rough in these Smash Ultimate streets.
Yeah, a lot of people, I mean, like, they just have not adapted to the game as well as you would think. I mean, and a lot of players, like, Fallen. Fallen is like, I don't really like Ultimate. And then he's also going to school. He's trying to get his MBA.
Yeah.
So you can't really fault him for that.
Exactly.
Larry's doing his best, but Larry, you know, is struggling a little bit to come to terms with Ultimate. So it's a tough world out here, but we'll see how Nico does here. Going to be playing Falcon, who I love to watch in this game.
Absolutely. Oh, Falcon's so exciting to watch. It's just unfortunate when you see the man get gimped or something like that. Falcon can go out so sad, but he can make other people go out horribly, just tragic. All right, nice snatch up right there real quick. Going to get these juggles off the platform.
Going to get the full jab. Yeah, you got to respect it. You got to hold on to that shield the whole time. Tries to get the up air underneath. That does create a trap, though. Gets the back air instead.
All right, okay, good up smash right there to catch him with a punish and an up air follow-up, too.
Yeah, I really love the up smash out of shield because having Falcon above you is just amazing. Because his landing options are so poor that, you know, surprise Falcon kick, not good at all. So Don really choosing the right option for that. Getting up air and actually dying for it?
I think he had the wrong DI. He was not prepared for him to get all the way back up there after that down air.
That was ugly.
Yeah, absolutely. So he's going to take him out, you know, for that first stock, but it's not over for Don yet if he can get his feet on the ground.
Not again. Okay, I thought he was going to go for another Nair.
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't actually go for knee or Nair, like you said. I mean, that's one of those situations where you can throw your stock away. I mean, you're up an entire stock, even if you don't make it back to stage, so what?
Yeah. From 20 to 53, Don trying to find his way to make it back. I feel like he should be very aggressive when Falcon is off stage. For the same reason you were saying, once Falcon's off stage, his recovery is so telegraphed.
Exactly.
And down air in the knee.
Man.
Yeah, it's so scary. You see him drift away. Like, I don't want smoke. I don't want smoke.
Exactly.
I don't want no trouble. Like, leave me alone.
And he tried to punch him with a down smash. Oh, it doesn't matter, though. The backer going to take him out. But was that backer?
Yeah.
It was too fast.
Soft hit.
Okay. But yeah, I like how Captain Falcon tried to get a down smash of his own on the ledge right there. The Wolf does it to everyone else. And that up smash, man, is lethal, but he's going to slip right out of it.
Yeah. He puts us all into it. You hear him screaming.
Yeah. Everything Captain Falcon does, he doesn't do it lightly, all right? He's really out here.
He's like Tony Robbins. He's like a motivational speaker. Like, be the best you.
Exactly.
Be all you can be.
He's really chasing this guy right now. He's trying to throw out these blasters right in his face, but he just jumps right over and gets this combo right
now. No. Come on. He's really feeling himself.
And he has no reason not to right now, all over Don.
Tries to get the back air, not going to happen. We've got the up air, but those are not as consistent as you would think. It's so hard to place them.
Right. Okay, the down air.
Boosh.
The knee almost going to get the soft hit and the
lingering. Okay.
Back air this time around. Can he get away? Oh.
I knew it. Did you know it? Because I knew it.
No.
Okay.
Did you know that?
Okay, no. I got to be real. I didn't know that killed
either. Really just Falcon kick? That's what I'm saying. I guess at that percent, sure, but okay.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah, Nico's showing us some new stuff. That first stock was a little bit closer than you would think, but he really came alive on the second one, finishing it out very strongly. Looked like we're going to Kalos for the next game, which I think makes sense Because I feel like whenever Don was, like, had to tech on that platform or was in the air,
right.
he's really struggling. He needs a lot more just flat, raw space, you know?
This is one of those annoying stages, though, I feel like, a little bit for edge guarding, because that platform
yes.
is right there in the way. You can almost, it messes up so many edge guard opportunities.
For sure.
But here we go. We'll see how he can deal with this. I mean, Don's the one who picked the stage, so hopefully he's got some things in mind for it. All right, quick chaser. So immediately going to go in with the nair. Nice up tilt follow-up, but turned around immediately by Niku.
What? What?
Oh, he teched it.
Beautiful tech by Niku.
How mad are you if you're Don and you picked the stage
Furious.
And you teched it? That would have been a stock anywhere else?
I'm quitting. That's it. I'm done. My Evo run is over.
Oh.
Up air into knee, not gonna land.
Okay, I'm glad he escaped that situation right there. Don't let it end that fast in under 30 seconds, man.
Down air to back air, good stuff. He's gonna chase him all the way off, or at least feign it. I like what Nico's doing.
Yeah.
Like, he's going all the way off, but he just kind of drifts back, and he's forcing Don to respect, like, he might do it, you know?
Exactly, and he is respecting that hard. All right, what that little float he did right there, get back on the stage. Love the landing with the up tilt. Lots of people like to wait for that and get the grab or something, but just catch them as they're landing.
Yeah, I feel like Wolves need to use that up tilt as much as possible. Whoa, landing into the knee.
Yeah, definitely use that knee as much as possible as well. Bring this back to an even game. Oh, okay, I like that.
Nice, yeah.
All that off of one fair.
Yeah, Wolves fair just sets up into so much
so
stuff.
So much.
I feel like Don should be going for that a lot more. Gets the roll in exactly what he needed. 93% is untouched, just barely getting hit by that. Oh, no.
Okay, yeah, I thought he was going to get that down air spike. Would have been a horrible spot for Don being only at 7% to lose his lead.
Yeah, but he gave up so much stage control for it.
Yeah.
And it's oh, no, the up tilt. He's going to be okay, but it put him in such a bad position. I feel like all this started because he went for that rogue down air,
exactly.
and now he's already taken, like, 66.
Okay, finally finding his way back on here aggressively, but it's being juggled up to the top. Great avoidance of that knee, though, and up smash going to close it out. Okay.
Yeah, and they did nerf that scoop just a little bit, but not quite enough for Niku there. Getting
still
rocked.
Still very good, definitely. Oh, that shield is tiny.
Yeah, he can't shield again. He cannot shield again.
Yeah, it was like, are you going to shield this or are you going to die?
Yep.
Like, which one? Die 2 seconds or die right now? Like, it's up to you. All right, chasing him right now, trying to get these, fares off the platform, but he's getting them right now. I'm surprised he didn't turn that around trying to catch him off stage.
I think what he tried to do is he was waiting for... Oh, he jumped into it, too! If he just waited for one more millisecond, I think he would have had it. There's the down air. Going to get the air dodge. If you can't get the knee, you're going to get the air dodge, which leads into more.
Right. Okay, trying to get another one. Oh, had the read on the jump, but not quite the positioning.
And Niku just playing the Falcon strength so well. Just so scary.
Right. Don trying to fight his way back in. This one, got to be careful. Good roll away on that. And now a punish opportunity, but doesn't take it.
Yeah, Niku just be smashing now. There's the back air against the shield. Looks like Don hit a button, comes out of the shield, meets that fist, and Niku with a little giggle.
Yeah, seriously, pimp slapped that
little
man.
Chuckle.
Just shrugged it off like it was no big deal. All right.
What a weird range of emotions that was.
Yeah,
he was like,
oh.
Like, what? Okay, all right.
Yeah, seriously,
how
happy,
do you really
sad,
feel?
Mad, rolled his eyes. I don't know. He's good with it. He got the win, so you know he's happy. Let's be real.
Yeah, good stuff
Niku
to Niku.
Always looks pissed off, though, honestly.
I think we talked about that at Thunder. They're like, are you okay?
Yeah,
like what's going on?
Niku,
why are you so
man?
Mad? He's just like,
he's
it's
like,
a murder
what?
Face.
Yeah, exactly. Some people just have that, like, resting, you know, B face, they say, or whatever.
Yeah.
Resting angry face. He's definitely got that, but, you know, good stuff to Niku either way.
Yeah, very good stuff. We got some more matches coming up for you guys, but first, we got some lovely slides from our lovely sponsors, starting off with Kwamba? Kwamba, right?
Kwamba.
Give me a thumbs up. Kwamba?
Sure.
Kamba, that's what it is. Okay. Yeah, I was on Jump Off with people who actually play fighting games, and they said Kwamba, so I'm going to blame them. Anyway, they make these excellent sticks. They got four different variations, as you can see here. I was looking at some of these. They look even better in person, particularly the Crystal, which is the one in the back. That is my favorite, guys. You can get these for 15% off site-wide at KambaUSA.com using the code EVO2019. Check it out.
Oh, and Gaming Generations, of course, as well. Professional event services, guys. They will set up your events, and they do an amazing job. They have all the setups and everything that you need. Just go to GamingGenerations.com. You need any tournaments run, they got you.
Also, DX Racer, I got one of these at my house. I actually need a new one, so I might take advantage of this. You got 20% off site-wide for EVO. Check it out. Use the code EVO2019, and you get a free upgrade to auto-lock casters. I can't tell you what that means.
But you get it.
It's not... It Okay, it locks the chair from move. I feel like that should be standard. All right, anyway, like you don't want. Okay, anyway, you could check it out, guys. This sale only runs from the 1st of August, 11 p.m. PST, to the 5th of August. So check it out, DXRacer.com.
And then China Gaming Market Solutions, guys, licensing, distribution, retail. Wait, what is this? Either way, you know, check them out. I'm sure there's a website or something somewhere you can click on. Great sponsors for this tournament right now.
Yeah, check it out. Also, good luck to all the competitors this weekend from Hyperkin. These guys make such great accessories for old retro gaming. You can check out the 3-in-1 HDTV cable that works for GameCube, N64, and Super Nintendo. You can find that right now. Also, you've got some premium wireless Bluetooth controllers that you can use. You can check that out right there. And even a Street Fighter band for Apple Watch. That's not out yet. Coming soon, as well as the BT controller. Check it out at HyperkinLab.com.
Looking. And then, of course, Skullgirls is coming soon in 2019 to Switch, and you can get the new PvP demo on mobile
on
for Skullgirls
mobile?
As well. Yeah, you can play both right now. Just visit at Skullgirls booth for the free Skullgirls swag as well. Okay.
You crazy for that one, Skullgirls. On mobile? That's wild. I got to try that. Mobile games are like, I don't know about you, my mobile games are like, I have like idle games, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Or just like total nonsense. It's nothing like that.
Yeah, it's interesting to see games like Fortnite and stuff like that moving over to mobile. Like, how exactly does that work?
That's nonsense.
Yeah.
I can't even imagine. Anyway, guys, we're going to kick it over to some video ads for some of our sponsors. Don't go anywhere. We're going to be right back.
shining right now. TK, I'm sure you're here too. Yeah. So let's go. Rido chants are filling the arena.
Yeah, man, it's actually all over. I hear some MVD as well, and I hear some Rido. So this is kind of, I'll say, I feel like they still like the fan favorites Rido, but it's almost cut down the middle.
Oh, yeah, definitely, man. You got to respect the performance he's putting on. Rido to continue his consistency. MVD creeping up on him a little bit here.
Go, MVD, said, get that can out of here. Not wasting no time. Gets the back air. He's sneaking these hits and twos and fews.
Got to make it count. Looks to go high. Rido chasing him down.
Rido managed to roll out that situation. Can all the way on the other side. Hasn't been able to explode. This could actually be a problem for him. Finally gets the explosion on the can, but it has to do the high recovery. MVD up throw. Wait.
Oh, MVD!
It's not enough.
Oh, that had me shook. Rido had to hold his breath on that one. MVD pulling out all the stops. Looking for the 2-0. It can be so taxing to play a character like Duck Hunt at times.
All right, man. And sometimes that hit, when it looks like you're so close to victory and you don't get it, sometimes that can shake a man, but hopefully it's not shaking MVD.
No doubt about it.
Back throw. Just barely gets away from it. Gets back on stage. The miss can.
Oh. Really can't go either way. That can is flying. That banana's in hand. The sheriff out there shooting too.
I'm telling you, man, NRA's fine. It's always coming through, bro.
You already know, man. I'll tell you what, brother. K-Kona.
K-Kona, brother.
Oh! 11-143 MVD. Diddy will not die.
All right. Put the can right in his face. Hey, you can take this back. Oh! Watch yourself.
Oh, the opening. Oh, he couldn't finish it. He couldn't finish MVD. Rido gifted perhaps a second chance at life. That grab is not enough, believe it or not. This man.
Okay, makes the juke away from that. I saw him use that recovery before. I really do like the way he's using barrel recovery to create that space. 168 to 113. Back on the other side. Still trying to figure out a way to get in here. Take
the
shot.
How many times, TK, is he going to take fight? Touch heaven, but not enter it. He's not ready. He sees the white light, but he doesn't want to enter. He wants the victory. You gotta stand up for that one. And that was only game two.
And we have a whole other game left. I know both these guys are standing up. They had to get their space. I mean, look, I know both these guys on that clinched.
I'm talking about tight.
All right.
I'm talking about a gnat couldn't find its way through. Clinched. All right. It's his Evo, man. You got to feel it. Oh, my Lord. Game three coming up, guys. Loser of this, out in seven. So much on the line.
Yeah, man. So here we are getting the counter picks. We are hard thinking right now, and that is expected. I mean, again, whoever does not win this will be out of the tournament. And I know these are some hard-fought battles, man. Oh, my God. What a way to end it, too, man. MVD living for so long, just for so long, but he just could not find a way. In fact, here we have a replay for you right now. Look at that, just right off the top, man. Look, 189, bro.
I'm telling you.
189. Man. It took him so, it was so long, such a hard-fought battle at the end of that, man. It really did come down to the last hit. If MVD got an up smash, even if he got like maybe a back air, he might have been able to take him
anything,
out.
Anything, man.
Like, it's just, ooh.
It seemed like there was a cut, like, at one moment where it looked like that up smash was going to be the ticket, but it just came, it fell a little bit short. But that will prompt us here. Game number three, Rido versus MVD. It has delivered on all cylinders. I have no doubt this will be an exciting, electrifying game number three. I can't pick a winner, but I'm damn sure excited to find out who comes out on top.
Most definitely, man. I honestly, like, this is like right down the middle for me. I can't even cheer, man. I'm just happy to see some great gameplay from two good competitors right now. Rido, MVD going at it. MVD, though, I don't know what's going on with his with his momentum, but it's definitely not there.
Yeah, man. Definitely seems like it shifted a little bit to Rido, though. MVD taking steps here to bring it back to the side.
Oh, watch yourself.
Would have loved to get that spike. That would have been a difference maker.
Still gets the banana too, walks up. The F smash, last second time, it's been broken by that can.
Yeah, that was kind of that small window where he could attempt that, but that can playing spoiler. Rido right on cue with his defense. And MVD, kind of a rocky start. He's definitely climbing back in this one. 144 now, however. And that's going to be the stock. Rido, the right place, right time. The up air striking, one stock away from advancing on and losers.
Yes. MVD, though, got some pretty decent damage on him. Got the 95. He's going to have to find a couple more hits before he's able to, you know, get that down tilt to up smash most likely. But a good up smash right here could take him out if he's able to even sneak that in. Goes for it again. Another break.
I'm telling you, man. Ronaldo just perfect on that defense.
Trying to get the dash attack in there. I was sneaky. Rolls away. Puts the shield up right in front of Ryno's face. Oh, another one. He's gone.
Nice. All right. Little betrayal from the can there. Aggressive play by MVD paying off. Only 27%, still anybody's game.
Most definitely, my man, EE. And this is looking super hard, though, for each competitor to really find out how they're going to, like, get that. Like, no one's really blowing up.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? No one's really just, yo, I'm doing 0 to 70 like it's nothing. Like, this is back and forth, man. This is back and forth.
It's the kind of contest you expected. Two sensational players. MVD, don't worry about validating your placement on the PGR, man. You've already done that. At this point, it's just all about taking it further. For Rido, it's all about pride. He loves to compete, loves to represent his country, and would love to get a big-time win here over a red-hot MVD. Can he do it, though? About 70% separating him right now.
Rido, so quick we'll get the can out there every time. Gets the dab. Getting that some fish, man. You ain't getting out of that no more.
Like,
112 to the 27, man. You know, MVD actually started the stock around 27, and he had just not been able to find that damage. Get himself back in the game. Another 33 right there, but that was mostly off of Rido's trade. Finally gets a throw. Oh,
okay.
And this is good.
MVD.
I see why he put he threw him that way. The can is way far behind him. Getting another grab. Dump.
Oh!
And he steals it from behind MVD. Moving on.
Was good, everybody. You saw that clip like 4 times. We're back. MVD Rido. Let me just get my professional
wire.
Yeah,
you're doing great right now. I like that.
Yeah, my bad, everybody. Oh. Anyway, we're back. I'm rocking the Evo thing. I got the ROG laptop in front of me.
Hey.
I'm going to be real with you guys. I need a laptop really bad. I'm going to find out if we get any kind of discount because, like, I'm such a moth. Because I see this RGB lighting, and I'm like, oh.
It's very cool, yeah. It's changing colors. Look at it.
I'm just such a – I'll fall for that every single time. I'm such a gamer.
Yeah, that's
what can
enough.
I say? I'm a gamer.
Oh, God.
And we got 2 other gamers coming up. We got Puppe coming up against DJ Mama. He had Rob Hovered, so I'm very glad that we're switching off to Pokemon Trainer. Thank God.
Oh, so we're going to do, like, an actual Pokemon fight right now. We got Jigglypuff versus Pokemon Trainer. Here we go. Here we go. And you rarely see Jigglypuff out here.
Not common, yeah. Jigglypuff just not common. Puppe, of course, coming freshly revealed off of the PGR. Do not have his number off the top of my head, but I remember it being really high.
Yeah, definitely did a great job at CEO, which landed him a much higher spot, taking that set off of Sam Sora and making his way into top 8 there.
Yeah, and oh my god, but DJ Mama having something to say, kind of stuffing him out and getting that forward smash. He's not somebody to mess with. This Jigglypuff coming out strong. Just looked it up, so Puppe actually number 28 on the PGR.
Okay.
And one of the big reasons that was such a big deal is because Samsara, if you look at his losses, he lost very rarely to people outside of the top 25. So Puppe taking that set is a huge boon.
Absolutely, and that up smash right there, bringing him back into this thing. It was looking like it was going all DJ Mama's way for a second there, but of course he's quick on the trigger with that.
110% on Puppe. He's got to get off this ledge, and I do not feel like Jigglypuff has amazing sort of ledge trap options.
Yeah.
She really wants to get off there, as you could tell there, but I mean, I don't know if he's going to be able to get that much off of, you know, Charizard getting off the ledge.
Exactly, yeah. Oh, and chasing her all over the stage right now. Got that first back air and then the up air follow-up. That's a light character, man. I wouldn't have been surprised if she had died to it.
Yeah. Puppe is staying true to form, known for his Charizard more than anything else.
Right.
Trying to rock him with this.
Ooh.
I don't know if that... Oh, wait. You know why that was smart? Because he went to Squirtle.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
That's so good.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, Rest was awful because he's going to Flare Blitz
exactly.
you. But
he
went to Squirtle. He's so smart. Good stuff to DJ Mama. I love that.
Yeah, and I do like that optimal punish right there off of the up B. And going to catch him once again. These quick combos. But that's the thing about Puppe that you can see happen often. If you hit his shield, he will up smash out of it immediately.
Yeah, especially if you're a floaty character like Jigglypuff.
Yeah.
You're
going
to be right up in that range. Puppe just racking up the damage with Squirtle, switching over to Ivysaur. I would not be surprised to see if he goes, you know, mostly
Yikes!
Jesus!
That
okay.
DI was very sus.
That was rough. Yeah, I would not be surprised if he switches over to Charizard again just because he loves it. He doesn't even need to Razor Leaf into the up air. Good stuff. And I'm not sure. I mean, you're from Puppe's region. I'm wondering if, you know, we had some changes to Ivysaur, had some changes to Charizard. I don't know how much he's played since the patch. It only came out a few days ago. But I wonder if – I saw him using a lot of Nair with Charizard, so
right.
I wonder if that – you know, that got changed. It's much stronger now.
Yeah. Oh, wait, so they nerfed Pokemon Trainer or Or I know Ivysaur got nerfed.
Yeah, it was like an adjustment. So okay. Charizard got buffs in really weird ways. So like forward smash is stronger, but like it was already strong. So
exactly.
Nair is way better. You can kind of land on people's shield with it now.
Okay.
Safely. It's really surprising. So I'm interested to see if Puppe has sort of those habits in his mind after playing for the past few days. Depends on how much he's played. He seems to be super strong here, but I was interested because, you know, as a Charizard aficionado, I thought that would sort of be, you know, how he started.
Oh, yeah, that's very fair. Yeah, he definitely did a good job in that last game, and, you know, we don't have to worry about the patch just yet. Okay, I thought he had SD for a second after that second down air.
Yeah, that was crazy, but he's gonna get the Vine Whip anyway. Good stuff, Puppe, just sharking under him.
Absolutely just cleaning that stock up, man. Only 6% on this Ivysaur. Oh, Jigglypuff trying to find her mark, though, barely whipping that grab. And gotta get out of the way of these up airs and the up B. And he taunted on this poor little Jigglypuff.
Yeah, what a disaster. I mean, like, Jigglypuff has to be in the air. And Ivysaur just throws out these huge hitboxes, which just...
Yeah, that's a fair point. She needs to be floating constantly, and you're going to get punished hard by a character like Ivysaur.
Covers so much space. It's tough.
Okay. Oh, with the switch into an up smash. All right, DJ Mama, if they're going to make something happen, it needs to be right now.
I mean, even if you make something happen, it's Puff. How are you going to make something happen three times?
You don't know about his rest combos.
I don't. You're
DJ
right.
DJ Mama going crazy. You don't know.
That was a really good punish that we saw in the first game off of the you know, the up B from Charizard, but you're not going to get those opportunities, especially on number 28 in the world.
Right, like, very rough spot to be in. DJ Mama had made it this far, man. He's trying to fight his way back in this, but this could be it, and it will be. Yeah. Goodbye.
Only 116 on the first stock. Puppe taking no joy in that victory, as you can see. Oh,
okay, there's a little smile.
All right, we're having a discussion. Okay.
Yeah, he is the type of player where you don't really see too much emotion from. Yeah. It's like what we were saying about Nico. He always just has, like, that serious face.
I like to imagine DJ Mama was like, I didn't mean to pick Jigglypuff.
he's like, I misclicked. Man.
I messed up twice. Yeah. And Troy, I call him Troy. Puppe's just like, Puppe's like, oh, okay.
He's like,
I won anyway.
Yeah,
I don't care. 2-0. I don't care.
Yeah.
You lose. Good stuff to Puppe. He's going to advance on. And coming up next, Sinji.
Sinji.
Who we thought was the... So as far as I know, Sinji was the first Pac-Man to ever make it on the PGR.
Okay.
And it looked like he was going to be the only one, but then T was like, nah.
He was like, let me show you something real quick.
Yeah.
With these ankle breakers, man. He destroyed me in that one set with E-Sam. I'm sure
Yep.
The dashback, forest man.
That was sick.
I stopped speaking English on that one.
Yeah, he was super nasty. But Sinji going to come up, of course, Pac-Man player from New York, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
Always see him going off at their locals. He's going up against Kenny, going to be playing Rosalina. See how this goes.
Yeah, okay, so Pac-Man Rosa. And yeah, Rosalina, another character that you don't see too much from.
Not at all. I feel like Wadi, one of the few people that will bust her out.
That was so long ago, too.
It was a very long time. Rosalina being played by Wadi a little bit a long time ago. Kind of dipping his toes into it.
Exactly.
And DeBuzz, of course, busting her out every once in a while. But like we were talking about Fallen, who was a top Rosalina player in Smash 4, has not made the transition due to various circumstances.
Right.
So Rosalina very much underplayed.
Is he still playing solo Rosa, though? Or
no.
Oh.
Fallen plays Robin.
Okay.
And it's funny because Fallen has like made it very clear his goal, and this is why he wants to try Hero, his goal isn't to go far in bracket. It's to make sure other people don't.
And that is exactly what Hero will do,
I'm
telling you. He is not going to win the tournament, mind you, but he will upset a top player.
He just wants to, like, he wants to be Wizrobe at Smash and Splash. Like, okay, Tweak, you don't get to play, and I'm going to go fight this Mii Brawler next. Like,
sorry. Yeah, exactly.
Sorry, brother. You're out.
It's just very interesting how it's going to go. I cannot wait to see how Hero changes up everything.
I don't know. I'm so excited for Smash. Like, as a player, I would be pissed at SmashCon allowing Hero.
Yeah.
As a commentator, I am thrilled.
I'll be laughing my butt off.
I cannot wait. This character is a revelation for commentators.
Yeah,
I cannot believe
it. That's absolutely true. Although, we are going to have to study the entire menu. So.
Oh, I'm making stuff up. Kalamo! Kashlammers! Hingle McKringle! I don't know what I'm saying.
And that's pretty close to the accurate name.
That's true.
So don't worry about it. But right now we're going to have Pac-Man go up against Rosalina. Two staples for Smash, of course.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised. So this matchup is going to be interesting because, like, Rosalina, of course, does have that gravitational pull. Can grab any projectile that is thrown at her and kind of, you know, bring it into her space. But Pac-Man was really buffed in this game and is like more of a fighter.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like he can fight you in close quarters now.
You see that happening right now, getting all in her space. Even though she's holding onto his orange, she could care less about it.
Yeah. And just talking from our region, I mean, we saw Mog kind of start out in Ultimate with Pac-Man get pretty far between the Pac-Man and the Richter.
Right.
So
right.
I'm interested to see, you know, just sort of what Pac-Man could do. That's really my frame of reference from locals.
Exactly.
Mog, of course, not making it out too much. I just wanted an excuse to shout him out because I love that guy.
Yeah, let's go, Mog.
Love watching him play. But Sinji is the premier Pac-Man, at least for the U.S.
Absolutely.
You can kind of see why here.
Yeah, got her trapped right now, throwing the hydrant down, but now a quick grab from Rosalina coming around, trying to read something with an up smash, but back air? I think it was?
Yeah, it can KO in this game. Not like that, I'm a little surprised, but I mean, like, Pac-Man, again, just has these strings and has a way to get that stock off.
Yeah, very odd the way he snuck that behind her. It seemed like he was right in front of her, and suddenly she was exploded out of here.
Definitely a cross-up, some kind of fuzzy.
Right.
Double up air, triple up air, quadra up air. Let's hit R. How about the, not now. All right, he got away with it. It's fine.
No, as long as it works. That orange right in her face, the cherry coming out, but it doesn't matter. It gets the fair, and now, oh, the hydrant's so close to catching her.
Yeah, just barely. There's the back door. Kenny with the edge guard. Bets on low, and that was not the option. What? With the Tootsie? All the way with the little toe? Oh, forward smash.
And Sinji
okay.
just pivoting, walking up to her very slowly. Make sure he catches that perfect spot. Gonna get Rosalina out of here.
And I like that because I think players can mix you up. You know what I mean?
Right,
like
yeah.
when you have that drift, you forward smash in the wrong direction.
You gotta take it slow. Ooh, that grab. Never been good, but it's better in this game now, but not from that positioning.
Yeah. Careful when we say good, we mean comparatively.
Exactly.
Like, not objectively
like it's
good.
It's actually a move now.
Yeah. Oh no, the water put. Yeah, Kenny's like, no, I'm out. Like, I'm not getting on this.
Yeah, you don't want to contest with that at all. And what happened to the apple? I swear Rosalina
I think she's
was holding,
holding
it.
All right, I think he dropped it.
Okay.
He was holding it for mad long, though.
Exactly.
You're right, yeah.
And that's one of those scenarios, too. I feel like characters like Pac-Man and others that use projectiles, they give you their item to hold to just mess up your options.
Yes, yep. Right now, 116, trying to find his way down. And Rosalina, her threat is, you got greedy.
Okay, Sinji was not ready to punch that. He's like, she won't go land.
Why
on
would
it.
You try to pick it up? Like, Sinji was like, no, you wouldn't do that. Ooh, you wouldn't do that either. Good down air by Kenny. I like that.
Yeah, gonna put him down in the bottom. Oh, okay, the apple actually gonna drop it onto him with a Z drop. I like it. Edge guard opportunity. All right, seems like Kenny's starting to figure things out just a little bit. Maybe too little too late, but can go into game two with a little better mindset.
Yeah, I mean, like, you can always get a little bit more data. I think if he was only one, like, if this was Sinji's last stock, we might have a game here. But
exactly.
I think having two stocks, especially against Pac-Man.
I was going to say, versus Pac-Man and someone like Sinji, who plays very patient and smart.
For sure.
He's not going to throw anything out to get punished too early, and only at 31% right now. Okay.
I think he tried to grab her as, like, the water was going to push her into it.
Yeah.
But I do really like Kenny's usage of that gravitational pull. It looks like he's always guessing right on when Sinji's going to throw it, because you need a little bit of a reaction. So I really like Kenny's usage there, but still not quite enough as they take a look at the stage for the next game.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, going to look at that little card. Very great. I love when tournaments put things like that out on the table, so you might not be familiar with the rules at each different event. Let's go, Evo.
Yeah, you need it for sure.
And definitely a rough game right there. It did look like Kenny was starting to figure it out towards the end, like I said, but he's going to need to play it just right if he's going to bring it back for something.
Yeah. So here we go. We're going to get into the next game. Don't know if we're going to see a swap. Like I said, Kenny is, I think, he asked if he's staying Pac-Man. Daisy!
Okay, this could definitely go a lot
better.
You
on Team Peach or Teach Peach?
Peach all day.
Okay, all right.
Are
we're done
Daisy?
Here.
Oh, my
Can
God.
I get a new caster?
Oh, my God.
Daisy is spunky!
Okay,
hello!
But hold on. Look at her hair. Tell me that's not a mustache.
Okay, well, now I'm Team Peach. You ruined her for me. Miss Pringles. You ruined her forever.
Good. Let's go, Peach.
She's like a 20s oil baron. I don't like her anymore.
That's why she's getting worked across the stage. But trying to find her mark right here, dropping the turnips. Oh, my God. The Galaga knocked into the hydrant. Just going to rack up so much on poor Daisy.
Yeah, poor girl.
Even I don't want to see her hurt that bad.
So we're at the Kalos against Pac-Man. That's a load of barnacles. I don't know about that.
And I love how he put the bell down into the water. It actually almost hit Kenny. That was so close.
Shot off super far.
Seriously.
101 right now on Daisy. Going to use that trampoline just for style points. Has the melon out. Good parry. Ooh, double?
Oh, my goodness. And Sinji just too smart when it comes to that Hydra. He knows exactly where it's going to be and how many hits it's going to take to knock it towards his opponent.
Triple parry. I love that throw into the air.
I love that, yeah.
Like he's just, and it goes nowhere.
Just gently. Nice little drift there.
Kenny's doing a good job of working with his projectiles, though. He's hit the last couple of turnips. As long as he can avoid that melon, I feel like I kind of like this stage pick now, because if he can get away from the ledge, if he could just hold center, Sinji, if he hits a back air, it's not going to KO.
Right.
He needs like an apple, he needs a bell setup, maybe the hydrant, but he doesn't have to worry about too much unless he jumps into it.
Exactly.
A little crazy.
He was actually doing a good job hitting those turnips over top of it, but it's not going to matter anymore. Bell into hydrant. Taking her out of this.
Yeah, I think Sinji got a whiff of what Kenny was doing. He's like, oh, you want to hold center? Now the hydrant's in center.
Right, but almost right there with that fair off the left side. Get the quick re-grab opportunity here for the edge guard. He needs this.
107 eating the key, 19%. And now I think the tables have flipped because Daisy can't really KO all that well unless she's off on the side. Like, as long as Sinji just holds this center, keeps the hydrant in front of him, and keeps his space, Kalos, I feel like this is a nightmare for Kenny. I don't know about this counterpick.
Absolutely, and the dot eye is so close to actually connecting and helping Kenny out with the stock. He just cannot seem to find it at all, like you said.
It's tough.
All right, going a little above ledge by accident, but he should be okay. Sinji was a little too far away to punish.
Got the Galaxian out. I don't know what his... Yeah, you don't really have a kill setup for that, just damage, but she's racking up so much. No way. Okay.
Okay, into the boots, and this girl's gonna need to be careful. She's gonna go for the trampoline. Oh, I took that away!
No, I need this. I need this.
Yeah, Sinji's a mastermind. How dare he even try to touch his trampoline?
Yeah, this is my property.
Yeah, no thank you, ma'am.
What the? All the way? All the way off, Sinji?
Yuck.
The triple boot? Definitely hit him with the Mr. Yuck. That was nasty.
Absolutely, and a great showing from Sinji right there. Like we said, the master of this character, and I can't believe he took the trampoline away from that poor young lady.
He didn't even need it.
He didn't.
Like, Pac-Man is so stingy. Like, you didn't need the trampoline there. Someone clearly needed. No, this is mine.
He didn't want her to have it. She thinks she could just take his stuff? Like, what's she done for him lately? No.
You ever, like, go into your backyard and somebody's just chilling in your pool?
Right, or you're on your trampoline? Like,
yeah, just a kid.
No.
Get the hell out of here. Get off my lawn. Good stuff to Sinji.
Yeah,
just
absolutely.
Taking it away. And the reaction time, because I feel like a lot of lesser players would have been like, okay, I need the key here.
Yeah,
or like, you know, like charging the bonus
fruit. Or
even
just sit there. Like, just let it happen and be like, okay, he'll recover and then I'll do this. Sinji's like, oh, I can take it away and he'll die.
Awesome stuff to Sinji. Just showing us why he's so highly ranked on the PGR. One of the top 50 players on the planet.
Oh, Sinji.
Yeah,
and
super talented.
I wonder if that was actually a bait, too, that he put it so low and she had to recover from the side. Like, maybe he wanted her to go
for that. See, now you're giving him too much credit. He's in the top 50. He's not in the top 10. He's not that nice.
You don't know what he's got going on.
That's true. Were you ever, like, in an English class and they were like, okay, there's a phrase that you use for authors. It's like, if it might be intentional, you assume that it is.
Okay,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, I've heard that kind of thing.
Yeah, so I think a lot of people want to give Sinji the benefit of the doubt. As a player, he's not that smart. I'm going to tell him that. I know he didn't mean to do it. I said it, not you. I'll take the heat.
Yeah, go ahead. When he comes and fights you in the parking lot later, I mean, I'm not going to help.
Sinji's going to bust me up.
You don't
Sinji's
know.
Like 5'2", bro. I'll beat him up. I don't care. Let him come for me. All right, anyway. Sinji's from New York. He's going to beat my ass. All right.
Yeah, exactly. This next match, though, we got Void sitting down versus, is it say Musaman?
Let's see. So we got Void against Musaman. Yeah, so Void actually, he's declared wolf.
Yeah, and wait, what?
Yeah.
I was going to say, I know he's not going to be using Pikachu anymore. He made a tweet about it, like, after this event, he doesn't want to use any
really?
More Pikachu. Yeah, or Pichu, excuse me.
Okay,
yeah,
Pichu.
He said that it's mentally taxing to him playing that character, and there's nobody else really doing it, and he likes to learn from other players,
for
but
sure.
There's no one else to learn from, so he just doesn't want to use the character anymore. I guess he's going for Wolf now.
Well, so it's funny. So I was in the we were in the Panda Suite, and I was talking with Isim, and he said that Void is switching over to Pikachu.
Oh, okay.
Time. Yeah. But he's not. He's playing Wolf.
Yeah,
here.
But he's not. That's interesting. Maybe he wants to take more time and learn Pikachu a little bit more, but I do feel like there would be a simple transference from Pichu to Pikachu, in a sense at least.
I think some things will transfer. I do think that Wolf is very much... So I play Wolf now, and it's because, like, Wolf does not have a bad move.
Yeah,
like,
that's very fair.
Everything is functional.
Lots of kill moves, lots of this move goes into that, into that, into that.
Right, like forward air is a forward air. Back air, there's very little nuance on the character.
Right.
So I feel like he's a very good character if you're just good.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's not one of those things where, oh, I lost because of, like, I went as far as I could with the character. I think Wolf can take you as far as the player can go, and Void, obviously, super talented, number 9 on the newly released PGRU, but I think he's in a lot of, he's kind of in the hot seat now.
Yeah.
He's in danger of falling lower next season, has not started off very strong with the season. At Thunder Smash 2 this past weekend, he actually placed dead last of all the competition.
Wow.
Now, keep in mind, it is an invitational.
Yeah, so everybody there is a top talent, but
exactly.
Still.
Definitely not a placing befitting somebody number 9 on the PGR, so we'll see how he does here. Wolf against Link.
Yeah, my man gonna go crazy. And also, to be fair, I don't think that Void was in full form at either Thunder Smash event.
I agree.
So, yeah, so we'll see how he can do right now at Evo, where, of course, he's gonna be taking this as serious as he can.
For sure.
All right, great chases right now with those forward airs. Going to catch him real quick. And a Link, also another character who there's not too much representation, of course. There's like Sova Unknown, other T.
Yep.
A couple others, but yeah, not too many. Musaman trying to put this character on the map.
Yeah, good stuff there, waiting for the get-up attack. Good read on the DI, too. I think a lot of Wolf players sort of react too late, and they'll go for the up throw into the forward air, but you can get the up air if they DI in.
Right.
Going to get that forward tilt. Just going to go for the down smash. Yeah, he went for it all.
Yeah, smart on Musaman to go high above the ledge. Seeing that the down smash was coming through from Wolf, he was hoping to avoid it, and he did just that. All right. Not putting really a mark, though. Just kind of stood there and allowed Void to get whatever he wanted.
Yeah, no real reaction. Uses the up B, goes to the side. I thought that was I thought he was going off.
Yeah,
that was a little scary.
Yeah, a very risky thing to do here. And smart on Void to wait it out this time, not just swing the down smash. He's going to catch him with the forward tilt.
Yeah, super smart on the forward tilt, too, because I think the down smash might have gotten touched or might have given him time to snap to the ledge. So I think the forward smash, just because it's, you know, a little bit transcendent, is able to reach a little bit further out horizontally. Super good.
Ooh, and that forward smash trying to catch him with the second hit of it, but not quite. The bomb up. Did not get the connection, though. And now down smashing his bomb.
Yeah, and I think picking up the bomb actually limited the combo because he had to throw it. You can't use an aerial after that. So Musaman actually getting away with a little bit there. But he upbees into him, just going to take the back throw. He could have gone for, like, a forward smash or something, but he wants to get him off the ledge instead.
Exactly. And it did seem like one of those scenarios where Void was not quite ready to punish, so he just kind of went for whatever he could get. Another up B. It's interesting seeing him go for that as a punish, but the up smash, not interesting. You know they're going to go for that.
For sure. I think he wanted the tech in place, which is why he ran at him like that. He didn't quite get the roll in. Like, a lot of Wolves would just charge down smash if they think it's roll in, but I think he thought he was just going to get the, you know, the normal get up tech.
Yeah.
So he betted on that. Was the forward air. Not going for a forward air string. Instead, going for the nair into more.
Excuse me, young man.
Okay, I was going to say.
Got himself back on the stage quickly. I would have been so sad for him.
I wasn't even watching him. I was like, wait, what? How'd he get into the magnifying glass?
Right. Don't put yourself in disadvantage. Oh, and the roll right towards Void, and he's going to catch you with the
down smash. No. That's enough.
You can't roll into Void twice, even though it was two different directions. Oh, he just went into style. That's what the up B was. The whole time, it was just style.
It's like an Agatha Christie thing. The whole time, that's what he wanted. His motives are revealed.
I am sorry for Musaman. He didn't deserve to go out like that, but he's still putting up a decent fight right now, trying to figure out what Void is going to do, which is incredibly hard, as we said, number 9 in the world.
Oh, but a decent fight. He got 3 stars.
Come on, man.
How is that? I know. We're trying to give him a... He's got the shirt on, bro.
Yeah,
like,
come on. He bought that.
Oh, that's tough. You saw Void nodding, like, all right, Link again. See how this one goes. I don't know, man. Number 9 in the world. And it's not like he switched off on something like, I don't know. Switching off to Wolf, like I said, is so good because Wolf just covers so many options. As opposed to like, okay, I'm going to go from Pichu to something. I'm trying to think of something that's really hard, that's good, but it takes you time to learn. Like Inkling.
Like
that is functional, but that can be a little bit easier to deal with, I think. Oh, goes low. I think he tried to pull out the bomb, but instead...
Yeah, did the boomerang by accident. Just a little too laggy, I guess. Wasn't able to get out of that.
Yeah, being on the stage can be tough. You know what I mean? Like, it can kind of mess you up.
All right, so trying to find something right now. Reflect on his boomerang, but not the bomb. Able to bring him up to even percents here, but stocks not so much. All right, quick fair into a nair, of course. Catch him off the ledge. Yeah, you can't get up attack. Void's waiting in the shield like that.
Yeah, you could tell really why Void is such a strong player. I mean, like, it seems like Musaman is continually get up attacking off the ledge. He's rolling in on tech options. And just, you know, not to take anything away from Musaman.
Nice.
This is like, you know, mid-level player habits. But the problem is that if you're going up against a character with so much experience as Void, he's going to get adapted to those. There's another roll in.
Yeah. And it just looked like Void was ready to punish it, but he just didn't truly believe he'd roll into him for a fifth time.
Yeah.
Yikes.
You're dead. You're not making it back. You're dead. You didn't die immediately, but you're dead.
It's like, you can stall it out if you want to, yeah. But, yeah.
Wait, could he have bombed?
I mean, if he had done it immediately, but... Maybe. I think he thought he was dead off the side B. I mean, the sparks and everything happened, so...
Well, if he could have bomb jumped, that would have been great.
He probably should have bomb jumped, but either should've way, he didn't. Right? He didn't, though.
He did not. He did not.
But yeah, that I was gonna say that's the thing about Void that I really respect too as a player. He is very reactionary.
Oh,
and,
for sure.
And he also has the read too. So just coupling the two together is a horrifying duo, and it makes him very hard to beat.
Super scary. Yeah, I'm interested to see how he does this weekend. Obviously, he's dealing with the character thing.
Yeah.
Probably more than anybody else. Like you've seen Myron struggle with the Olimar nerfs, but like Shutone and DeBuzz still showing that it can be done.
Mm-hmm.
Myron has his days. But I think that Void probably is the poster child for, like, you took him away.
Yeah.
You killed my character, you know?
That's so sad, because it was pretty much only Void playing the character anyway.
Right.
There was, like, two or three more, maybe, but not quite on his level.
Yeah, I think you see a lot of that. Like, if you look at the top 10 for the PGRU, I think there's only one repeat character, because you have, you know, obviously, you have Joker at first, you have, what, Wario, and then a billion characters for Tweak at second, you have Zero Suit at third, and then, like, the only repeat character is Olimar, so it's very well balanced.
Mm-hmm.
But Pichu just, it's funny, because I think in other games, your characters will kind of go in and out of season, so, like, League of Legends, it's like, okay, this character is good right now, or it's not, but it's very rare. Like, in Smash 4, we saw some characters that didn't exist.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, Mewtwo is just, oh, he works now.
Yeah, they were like, let's fix him up real quick.
Yeah.
And then suddenly you got people like Wadi topping the charts all of a sudden.
Yeah, Mewtwo has bloomed, you know? And it's a weird thing, but I think Pichu is the only example of a character in this game that is just like, okay, off.
Yeah, you don't get to be meta anymore, sorry.
Yeah,
that's unfortunate.
Just...
I thought he was going to wait till after Evo, though. I could have sworn Void said he was going to wait till after. But maybe he said for the next PGR season, so I guess that starts right now.
Yeah. So here we go. It looks like up next, we've got Rickles coming up. Everybody's favorite Ganon player.
Oh, Rickles?
This is my boy up against Nezergy.
Definitely everybody's favorite Ganon. And I want to see what he can do right now. And you said versus Nezergy, who's a Meta Knight, another character I just don't see very often.
Yeah, not common at all. Interested to see how Ganon against Meta Knight is going to go. I feel like Rickles, obviously, probably the favorite on this. Nezergy playing Meta Knight can really do some damage off stage with Gimps, but the problem like on stage, if you get hit four times, Meta Knight's dead.
Yeah, and that's the thing about these types of matchups where you're like, oh yeah, just Gimp him. It's like, okay, but how do I get him off stage in the first place?
Good luck.
You got to start learning that portion of it, because you can't go into a matchup versus like, Little Mac or something like, just Gimp him. I mean, that's very easy to do, but you still got to get him off stage in the first place.
Yeah.
All right, but here we go. For Leon, says Rickles. Going into this, playing for someone else. And meanwhile, we got, I guess, for Project M over there.
I wasn't going to say it. You said it.
I mean, not that. What is that?
I've never heard of that.
Never heard of that.
All right, there we go. Flame choke. Good tech on that.
Definitely something got to learn for this matchup.
For sure.
That can make or break your set versus a Ganondorf.
Yeah. See, good dash tech into the up air. Can't quite keep the string going. Ooh, dashing away. And I think the key to the Ganondorf matchup, just how to beat the character in general, is you have to wait. You have to be patient. Wait
Absolutely.
For Ganon to commit, and then you can punish him. But it looks like Nezergy really using his multi-game smarts. He knows what the character is going to do, and he's playing around it, teching away again.
Yeah.
And he knows that the only thing Ganon can really do there is a dash tech or a wizard's foot. I think if you tech in on Ganon, the options are way scarier. Good forward smash, getting that stock.
Definitely an excellent guess or catch. I was going to say both of these two guessing each other's options so easily.
Yes.
Seems like they definitely have the read, and right there, he's going to catch him with the forward air, take him off the side.
Yeah, and that's just such a disaster. You want to get some damage off. Gonna get
20%. Definitely not the best feeling. And now look at how even it is. Leon, got to be careful getting on the stage here, or Rickles, rather.
Tech in place, tech away again, even with no spot there. Silly me for trying to call it out, but
See, that's the thing, you wouldn't expect them to go for it for like a third or fourth time, but that's the mix-up.
Oh, tech in, Rickles is ready for that one, getting the up smash. See what the punish is, dash. Yeah, he's just going to get the back throw.
Yeah, and I like how he dipped low. Oh, okay, great dash attack. But yeah, good dip low to avoid anything that Project M could have wanted to put out there.
Yeah.
Or I want to call him Nezergy. Okay, Nezergy.
Yeah. And you can tell he's a little scared to go off stage. I feel like you have to do that against Ganon, especially as a multi-jump character. You have to be a little bit brave to go for it. There we go. We got some up airs coming out into the down air. Good read on the tech in.
Yeah, that's the thing. Once again, catching each other with these reads on where they're going to be after the hit. Oh, that tiny shield. He couldn't afford to shield it anymore. Okay, I like how he's starting to use these dimensional capes to get out of the way. It's a little bit more of a mix-up.
Yeah, just trying to escape.
Yeah, fishing for way too many back airs. Rickles, of course, knows how to counter that situation. One of the down smash.
Yeah, I like the tech in place, just trying to cover that. Goes for the Super Knight. He's going to get it. Shout out to DM. I know you're watching. 94% on Nezergy. Let's see what we can get out of this. He needs a strength. Watch the air dodge to come out from Rickles. There it is.
Oh, yeah,
he's going to go in.
And now he lost his opportunity to make something crazy happen. And now Flame Choke, but good get up attack. That's been working actually pretty well. And another chance for the ladder. No way, no way, no way,
yes!
No way.
Yes way. I think he DI'd in.
Oh, he popped off too.
Wouldn't you?
Yeah, I mean, yes. He brought it all the way back.
Good stuff to Nezergy, pulling it out. Pulling out the ladder. We don't see any of that anymore. That
none
is not
that,
common.
Yeah. Not a single character that had a ladder in the last game feels like they have what they had before.
Yeah.
So good on Meta Knight to actually make that happen. I'm surprised he died from it. Should he have died? There was no sparks. Was it bad to die?
I want to say no, but because like I never see Meta Knight, so
right.
I could
yeah,
be
you
wrong.
You can't really say, yeah.
I don't know. Maybe I'm going to say no.
Okay, sure.
Rickles, if you're watching this back, shame on you. You should not have done that.
Tisk, tisk.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe he was trying to SDI out. I couldn't tell you.
Right, that could be a thing.
It looked like he went in when he should have gone out. But, I mean, Rickles, you know, who knows? When you're in that frame of mind, when you're kind of panicking, you know, that could definitely happen.
Definitely.
Have to see how he does here. Rickles was playing so well up until that point, getting so many options correct on the Flame Choke. So I think that's really how his bread and butter. But look at that. You saw Nezergy call out the Wizard's Foot immediately and punish it.
And it was from so far away. You do need to be a little bit careful going for something like that. Even if you have the read at that distance, they can react.
Yeah. And Rickles, we know he's such a talented player coming from the Midwest. Probably the premier Ganon, I would say, at least in the U.S. But the problem is, you could tell Nezergy knows how to fight against Ganondorf. He's done this a lot.
Yeah, and I love that upbeat right there, going as far to the right as he could to hopefully hit Nezergy out of that forward smash. Ooh, okay, great spot dodge right there. Gonna take Rickles off, and he has no option but to jump there.
Yeah. I mean, when you're that far off as Ganondorf, it's so hard. Rickles just stuck, getting the Super Knight again. We got 12% there. But Nezergy isn't really at that scary. Like, being at 75 can be scary, but you're going to take a couple more hits, getting the tornado.
Oh, he doesn't have his jump. Oh, he did have his jump. I thought
saved
he hit him
it.
Right out of it.
I thought so. I thought he used it before.
Yeah,
but
okay.
Rickles, I mean, that is the beautiful Ganon veteran game knowledge. Holding on to the jump as long as he can, calling out the tech in place and getting that kick. Oh, he's going to take him off. Nezergy a little hungry for that one. He's going to pay.
Okay. He's going to make this an even game immediately. Now let's see what he can do. Immediately getting hit by that up air string once again, though. Good on the escape.
But all those hits do not amount to four hits on Ganon. Rickles bringing it back.
And the parry? Oh, and he read that man's life away. Ooh. Ooh.
Ouch.
They're both laughing it up. The last two games' endings have been absolutely explosive.
I wouldn't be laughing. That hurt. He, like, tore his guts out. He's like, I'm disemboweled.
Anyway, where'd he ban?
I'm in great danger.
Right.
I am terrified for the third game.
I mean, and they both honestly should be.
Yeah.
This has been a very interesting set right now, and I cannot believe he went for the Flame Choke off stage.
That was nonsense. You know what, though? I love sets like these because, like, this is very clearly, like, Rickles, a veteran Ganon, has been playing the character for a very long time.
Yeah.
Extremely talented. Everybody knows him. Nezergy, not a player I think on many people's radars, at least for Ultimate.
Yeah.
But you can tell he knows this matchup. He knows Ganon's flaws sort of in his design as a character. And I think that this is just sort of a masterclass in how to play the character. And I love this stage choice. We're going to town and city because the platforms can really mess up Ganon, can make it hard for him to land. It's way bigger, so it makes Ganon's kill power a lot less scary.
Right?
This isn't just, you know, a good player against the scrub. Both of these guys, very talented.
For sure, and both of them, like you said, just showing a display of a character we don't see too much, and these are definitely the specialists of them.
Yeah.
Excuse me, a Warlock punch, sir? I don't think he meant to do that.
I feel like he's already in his head after the way that last one ended. He's like, you know what? How deep am I? Like, which lobe of the brain am I in? Oh, I'm just in the frontal cortex. All right, that's fine.
Yeah, I mean, maybe that was just a shake him up for something else. And sometimes it's about sending that message, you know?
Yes.
Like, I'm not scared to do anything. Ooh, barely missing that forward smash. Gonna get the shield up just in time.
Tech in, good stuff. Gonna get the double dash
Ooh,
tech.
Air dodge down, dangerous.
And he waits for it. I think Rickles is going a little crazy with these air dodges.
Yeah.
Nezergy is always ready for it.
He needs to be careful and getting his fingers back on the stage just barely right there. But the rapid jab's gonna hit him with the tip of it.
Beautiful recovery. Yeah, I love that recovery from Nezergene. Roll away? No, we're going to tech in place. Just gets the wizard's foot.
Yeah, and I think he also read the roll away. That's why he went for that. But, of course, didn't tech it this time. You're going to get hit by the down tilt.
Yeah. And for anybody wondering, you always want to tech. I mean, like, it seems like, you know, maybe you'll have the no tech mix up, but that gives you no options in terms of functionality.
Yeah, no, you're just
dead. You always want to tech. There's no reason not to.
Right. Ooh, gonna read him on that dash attack. And he taunted with it too, just to show he is not scared of what you're gonna put out here, Rickles. Okay, but.
Oh,
reading him again.
No!
That did so much!
The big pull off. Good stuff by Rickles. No taunt either. He's trying to finish his plate.
Yeah, no, it's time to play real serious.
Yeah, no jokes. Oh, no. Oh, I love the reverse back here. That's what he needed. Nezergy took him all the way up. We're to a one-stop game.
All right, this is exactly where we were in game two. And now Rickles trying to bring that momentum back in that he had before. Flame choke to the dash attack follow-up. Reading this man. He's got to stay on top of it.
And you can tell Nezergy trying to scare him off with the down airs, but it's not happening. Rickles will not be afraid. He air dodges back to the stage. He's got to watch that. Ooh. Tech's in place.
Right, you saw him do a spot dodge as well, looking a little shook, but no. Going to get the flame choke into the down tilt once again.
No. Come on.
No, thank you.
None of that. Oh, no.
Not gonna
and Nezergy just continually getting hit by these flame chokes. We've got a ladder.
Oh my
Will
gosh.
He finish it off? Okay. He knows he can't finish it, so he just gets the back air. He's got to watch the flame choke. He's got to watch his jumps, and he's got to watch that neutral air. Rickles going to take it over Nezergy in a nail-biter of a set.
Excellent stuff right there. And I think that was like the first time he had jumped out of that situation.
Yeah.
But Rickles was ready for the mix-up. Okay.
That was so. That's my favorite set I've seen.
Absolutely.
Like, that was so cool. Oh, my God.
Absolutely. Every single game of it, not to mention.
Yeah,
what
absolutely thrilling.
And I love that he was able to bring back game two off of holding onto that jump we both thought he lost.
Yes.
And then came back and won the entire set for it.
Yeah, and Nezergy just, to his credit, bringing back that stock into the third one with that extremely smooth down throw into the reverse down air.
Nasty.
That's not something you see at this point in the tournament.
Right.
That's like round four or five. Like, that's a treat. I don't know how we got to see that this early. Guys, if you're watching this back, I guess we wouldn't see this because the VOD is going to cut off. But, oh, my God, what a heart racer.
Yeah,
that was awesome.
Excellent match right there. Definitely the most exciting one for the day, I'd say.
Yeah.
How are they going to follow this one up? Who we even got? Oh, Meister.
Yeah.
Okay, another person who is, you know, pretty much a solo main of the whole character. I don't know really too many others playing this other than, like, Dingus Joe from MDVA as well.
Sure.
And then Foop on the other side playing Roy.
Yeah, so Meister is an interesting case. Obviously, he just had a killer run at Smash
right,
Factor going super
did.
Far, beating so many talented players. And really sort of having people re-examine Game & Watch. They're like,
wait a
that upbeat's kind of dumb.
Wait a minute.
Should he be allowed to do
that? And why does he got that bucket and nine? Hold on a minute.
Yeah, this character is the original hero. He's nonsense.
right. Yeah. Gotta test your luck with a character like this. But Foop on the other side playing Roy. We were talking about it earlier, you know, Krom and Roy, the two characters that everybody was like, oh, they're best in the game way back when. And now still got some stuff for sure.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting because you see random Kroms kind of pop off.
Yeah.
Like, you see Rivers, obviously. Mr. R could sometimes make an upset or two. Mr. R, of course, struggling a bit more in this game. But Krom has not really lived up to the reputation that
exactly,
a lot of people have said.
Exactly, that everyone pasted onto him.
Yeah. And then on the Roy side, obviously, you have, like, Hyper Kirby. You have Goblin, I think, is obviously
the
most.
I think Tweak played Roy at least for, like, a week
did.
Or something.
Yeah, but Tweak will play anybody.
Yeah, like, that's fair.
You can't really throw that on him. By the way, I'm going to be super biased here. Big shout-outs to Tweak for second. I'm so glad he got that. I was worried about Mars taking second. I love both of them. They're my two favorite players. But I wanted Tweak to get second. That's my boy.
Yeah,
anyway.
Definitely proud of everybody. Congrats on the PGR, man. But yeah, here
congrats
we go.
Congrats to Wadi, of course.
You know, and Meister, I'm pretty sure he's on.
I don't think so, actually.
Well, either way, he's on the stage right
next,
now.
Next one, though. He's starting out seeming too strong. So here we go. We're on PS2 because PS2 make the best games, as we know. It's dead even between these guys. There's the jab. Yeah, and I feel like between Chef, jab, up B, and dash attack, even back air, like, Game & Watch is, like, weird.
Yeah, he's got some stuff. It doesn't seem, you know, busted in any type of way, but look at this jab lock trying to go into a nine. Gets
oh,
all those
a feast.
Apples.
We mad healthy. We on keto. Well done.
Yeah,
losing 15 pounds in a month.
And then getting that forward tilt, taking him off the stage, and the timing on that. How dare he stand at ledge, honestly.
That's what you get.
All right, Foop trying to figure this one out right now. Like we're saying, Game Watch, a very weird character with, like, nobody to practice the matchup with.
Yeah.
Gonna have to learn it right here, right now.
So we got the down throw into the five. We're not gonna go for the nine. Okay.
Ooh, don't jump. Okay.
Yeah, please don't. It's like Mega Man. Like,
exactly.
Like, just unbind your controller for a second.
Right, that's one of those weird, you know, moves that you've got to be careful of the wind box on.
Yes.
Not too many of that in this game. Smash 4 had way more wind box situations, but yeah, Meister going to show him he needs to learn how to get past these sausages.
I hate that. That is my least favorite thing, when I'm just being pelleted
yes.
by breakfast meats.
Okay. Use the bomb, actually, to extend that hitbox right
Big
there.
Big chop.
Very smart, but still down an entire stock. But good on him to bring it back a little bit.
By the way, I'm going to throw this out at you. Did you know that Game Watch can control where the meat goes?
Oh, really? Oh, yeah. I knew he could do it, like, shorter or farther. But can he do it, like, up and down as
I
well?
I don't.
Oh.
Commentator, by the way.
Right, commentator. Yeah. Evo commentator, by the way.
Whatever. Whoa! Ooh. Let's go, Foop! While we were talking about breakfast meats,
yeah,
Foop has
like,
brought this
attention.
All the way back.
Watch
yeah.
this right now.
All
right,
good
great.
Stuff.
Yeah, bringing this back to even immediately versus, you know, one of the best players in the world
yeah,
right now.
Yeah, no question. I mean, definitely one of the best in Mexico. Getting the nine, but a perfect tech by Foop getting out of there.
That's got to feel bad if you're Game & Watch right now, but still racking up all this percentage, not too far down here. Is yeah. Foop. He could easily bring this back.
He's got to find his way back down. He's going to get the down throw into the up air. You have to respect Game & Watch, though, because he has that double jump into the down air. Foop getting hit by the down tilt. No, he tries to challenge that.
That still has super armor, right, from Smash 4
yeah,
as well?
Yeah,
you got to be careful going against, you know, any of those up smashes where they cock back the neck and go forward, man. Don't mess with Mario, Luigi, Game Watch, none of them.
Yeah, too scary. And especially, like, you got to – Gimmer's literally laughing. I can see Gimmer in the back.
The Gims always win.
He's having a giggle. Yeah, he's just
– As long as his character wins, he's happy out here.
Yeah. But, okay. Yeah, you got to – if you are going to do it, you got to space.
Yeah,
because, like, maybe you could challenge it off on the side if you're going in from behind. Maybe, but it's just not going to happen. Here we go to game two. But Foop definitely showing that he can make it rock, especially considering Roy's kill power. If he can get that double-edged dance off on the side, Game Watch will die incredibly early.
Yeah, that is very true. He's got to be being such a light character, too.
Yes.
Got to watch out. But he's definitely using that to his advantage, like with the air mobility drift that you get for being a light, floaty-ish character.
Yeah.
It's doing okay, but right now, Foop trying to work his way in this lead.
Yeah, I think Foop is playing a little bit more on his back foot. You can see him holding center. He wants to keep stage control and force Meister to come to him. You can tell he can't get off the ledge. Foop, I really like this counter pick. I feel like it's working for him. Nice!
For sure, and catching him off the roll with that forward smash right now. Meister, gotta be careful getting on the stage once again.
And that's a habit that a lot of people have. If Roy jabs your shield, a lot of people sort of instinctively just roll forward, and Foop catching wind of that.
Very smart right there. Once again, with another edge guard opportunity.
Nice. Ooh. I love that. Catching that roll in. Foop calling out the option there.
Yeah, he's reading every single one of these rolls from Meister. He needs to be a bit careful.
No. Oh, that's bad.
The oops. He could have went for one of those sausages, too, to extend the up B, like up B into it and then up B again.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, not ready for it.
Yeah, and that sucks. I don't like seeing that, like,
right,
when somebody is just looking so strong starting out. I don't know if it's, like, Evo main stage nerves or what.
Could definitely be a thing.
Really tough.
Especially when you're in the lead versus someone who you're seeded to lose to.
Yeah.
And right now, look at this reversal. Yeah, I think he lost so much momentum from that situation.
It gets in your head. He's going to get under that, going to use the double-edged dance, using the downward one, trying to do the most damage. Nice, and you
Very
can tell
smart.
He knows the uppie's coming, and he knows the down air is coming right after it.
Didn't seem like he was ready for that bomb, though. Got to be careful getting on stage. So many of them, and he doesn't dodge that one.
Yeah, get up
Did
attack.
He get up attack? Yeah,
yeah,
that's not the best.
Get up attack is not the play, and Meister trying to get in his head. I don't know if that taunt was the most polite thing to do.
Hey, but it's very smart. You got to utilize anything, whether it's in-game or out, man.
Yeah.
Do what you got to do to win.
Trying to do it big for Mexico.
Exactly.
Getting the nair into the other up air, and Foop just having trouble landing, air dodging through him. Weird option.
All right, throwing more sausages at this man, trying to stop him from being able to approach freely. And it does seem like such a struggle to get through those projectiles as a character like Roy.
Yeah, especially when you're off stage. I like what he went for there. That would have been very cute. But no, Foop just snatching the ledge. And this might be a foregone conclusion unless Foop can make something happen.
How can he get his feet back on the stage? And good on Meister, just go back to the sausage game, put the chair in his face. Man, still living for now, but oh my God.
Oh boy.
That would have been the spiciest nine ever.
Yeah. That would have been on the replay for next year,
sure. All right, trying to get the down tilt just to knock him off the stage with a bomb. I'm gonna do it. So a 2-0 for Meister over Fuchs.
Yeah. Did his best, looking very strong, but it really came down to that SD when he dodged off stage. I think, I don't know if it was a buffered thing. I don't know if he tried to, like, go up and to the right.
Right.
Like, maybe he thought, like, okay, well, I'll just go, you know, I'll immediately get back on stage. But,
either way, it didn't happen, and that took all of his momentum away, shifted it right over to Meister. Then he got in his head with his taunt and everything. He was get-up attacking bomb from above him. That's just not it.
Yeah.
Very unfortunate.
Very tough, but good stuff to Meister playing to his seed. No doubt. I'm sure we're going to see him get super far in this tournament. But keep in mind, everybody, this is 2 out of 3 up until finals.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a different kind of player that gets that far. I think Game & Watch is going to be especially strong, if I'm being honest, just because it takes you a little while to get used to some stuff like up at a shield.
Definitely. And it did look like Fu could have came around to that in Game 3.
Yeah. I think that might be... a little tough to see how far he gets. Guys, we're going to have some more matches coming up for you very shortly. With so many players in the building, so many top players, it's going to be so tough to, like, could you imagine trying to do a fantasy bracket here?
Seriously, like, would be very exciting, though. What do you got for top 8?
Oh, don't ask me that.
All right, at least
come
one
on.
Person you think will be in top 8.
Leo.
Okay, come on. Not Leo or Tweak.
Tweak.
Come on.
I got Mars. I got to say Mars.
All right, so give me top 8 then. You got 3 right there.
That's actually true.
Five more? Go
you,
on.
You got to have, like, somebody out of left field. I don't know if Rivers is here.
Okay.
I really want Rivers to make it.
Yeah, give me a random person you think could jump in there.
Oh, God.
Mm.
Somebody who could, like, pop off out of nowhere?
Yeah.
Well, it has to be a good character. Because
right.
I feel like at certain events, certain weird, bad characters can pop off.
That's true.
With 3,500, you're not... Well, then again, it's 2 out of 3.
Yeah, that's the thing. And especially in pools, random upsets happen all the time. There hasn't been too many here, like you said, but
yeah. I was going to say, I don't think a random character can get that far in like a 3,500.
Get it random.
Come on. I don't think they could get that far in a 2 out of 3 3,500-man bracket because that's too many people.
Yeah, that's
like, you
that's
can't beat that many people.
Exactly.
But I just... I'm trying. Chat, help me out. Throw me out who you want to
see. Who do you want to
see? In top 8. You're going to be wrong because you guys like some dumb people who aren't going to make it anywhere.
Damn. Oh, my.
But some of you guys might be right. I wanted to say Leon, but Leon isn't going to do it.
Yeah, he would have, though. Absolutely. If he was able to make it out here.
Yeah. I don't know. We'll see. I'm very interested to see. We're going to have the main stage on Sunday. We're going to see... the top 8
we will see.
People. It's going on last. We're going to be closing
out
EVO.
Actually, no bias. Wadi is getting top 8. No bias.
With Rob?
Yeah.
Rob's getting top 8.
And We Fit.
Okay, and We Fit. You got me.
Hey,
you got me on that. All right. I love We Fit.
Same.
I don't know if you know.
Very interesting character.
I feel like We Fit is like legitimately one of the sleepiest characters in the game.
Yeah, yeah. Like, I feel like it should have way more representation than she does.
I agree. It's such a wonky character that, like, nobody's using her. But anyway, guys, we're going to kick it over to our next block of casters. Thank you so much for rocking with us. We're going to have more EVO action happening. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned. We're going to have some more pools happen up very shortly.
We will.